This is an experiment in makeup for an experience in imagination and terror. We should like to present a design for a film of Pierre Boulle's finest book since Bridge on the River Kwai, his novel, Planet of the Apes. In this brief film, as in our intended picture, Charlton Heston plays the role of the astronaut Thomas and Edward G. Robinson, Dr. Zaius. His name was Thomas. Together with two other astronauts, one of them a scientist, he left the Earth for an exploration of the star Betelgeuse, some 15 light years away. But something went awry and they were forced to land on the nearest refuge, a planet which was unknown to Thomas. Their ship came down on an uninhabited and barren terrain. They tested the atmosphere, found it breathable, and set forth in their exploration vehicle. They found themselves entering a wooded section of the country. Suddenly, they were startled to see coming toward them a group of human beings, unclothed, unkempt, but human. In front was one of the most beautiful women Thomas had ever seen. The stillness of the jungle air was shattered by the unmistakable sound of aircraft motors. There, roaring toward the large clearing in the jungle, were several helicopters. In a moment, the air was full of screams and shouts of terror as hundreds of people poured out of the jungle in panic. The helicopters had located a tribe of human beings, and the armored cars were driving them out of the jungle. The men, women, and children were being mercilessly shot down by the guns of the hunters. Thomas's horror at this was nothing to the shock he received when he suddenly realized that the hunters were apes. Suddenly, he felt a hot, searing pain and passed out. When he recovered, he found himself caged as an animal in some kind of a huge hall, which also held other humans. Thomas finally came to understand that on this planet, the evolutionary process had somehow been reversed, for here apes were the intelligent beings, and man the animal, useful only for experiments in zoos. Held in a cage and filled with frustration, Thomas finally made his captors understand that he was different from the uncivilized human beings that inhabited their planet. Given an audience before a meeting of the chief scientists, he explained that he had come from Earth and was indeed a rational and reasoning human being. One day, Thomas was taken to the site of some archaeological excavations on which their scientists were working. One evening, shortly after his arrival, an incident occurred which was to begin a series of harrowing adventures on the planet of the apes.
I've been kept in a cage for 6 weeks. I'm fine, yes.
Good. Some of us will be returning to the city. This gives me an opportunity to say goodbye.
Won't you be coming back here to the excavations?
You won't be returning to the city.
Why not, Doctor? Is it the caskets you found?
Yes, I've seen those caskets and the headstones. Of some long-range interest to the archaeologists, perhaps.
Nothing more than that.
The findings in those excavations point up very little not already surmised. There has been somewhat of an affectionate bond between the master and the animal. The ape has been civilized for 1,000 years, Mr. Thomas.
And the man?
The man. Archaeology, your line, Mr. Thomas?
Just a hobby, Dr. Zaius.
You're quite remarkable. You go from the floor of a cage to the holder of scientific opinions in the space of a month and a half. Given more time, I wonder how far you would go.
I think the question is how far you'd let me go. me or any of my kind, for that matter.
Your kind? I don't think that question will ever likely be put to a test, Mr. Thomas. Man here is an animal. Man here was an animal. He had no civilization. He wore no clothes. He thought no thoughts. He spoke no language.
Just a few feet from this tent, you found a cemetery. Built and filled by a civilized race. A race which, according to you, never got beyond a crawl and a couple of grunts. You found more than a cemetery, Doctor. You found a question. Which came first, the chicken or the egg, the ape or the man?
Dr. Zayas, you'd better take a look at this. We found it in some kind of artificial shaft.
What do you think you found, Mr. Cornelius?
Not found, Doctor. Lost. And I'm afraid that would be a birthright.
Mama! Mama!
They had a language. While we swung from trees, they had a language.
You're right, Mr. Thomas. We have uncovered a question. Now we must unearth an answer. If man had a civilization here, what happened to it?
You better go out there and supervise the preparations for our departure.
I'm a menace now. Is that it?
Way down deep in my own consciousness and my own awareness, as deep perhaps as a basic instinct, I've known that you were a menace. I've known that man is a menace. You see, Mr. Thomas, I know all about man. I think his wisdom must go hand in hand with his idiocy. His emotions must conquer his logic. He's a belligerent animal who gives battle to everything he comes in contact with, and in the process, he will always destroy himself. That is what we've dug up out of a hole, Mr. Thomas. The truth. We apes have no death wish.
Dr. Zayas, hasn't it occurred to you that back on Earth, man has become civilized, finally civilized? I'm proof of that. Proof that man's reached out for the stars. For the first time in the history of mankind, maybe the history of the universe, man is not a destroyer, not anymore.
Well, if that be indeed truth, we've come close to a millennium. But this planet cannot afford to take that risk. We're not going to put it to a test. We will expect you to leave, Mr. Thomas, forever.
That's assuming I can get my ship back into the air again.
I pray that you can. The alternative must be obvious. So long as you live amongst us, you threaten us. Dwell on that.